to offer my condolences to the family and friends of Molly again. Although I did not know personally the vibrant sisters and child, I feel they are my family. I feel before this community that stands in awareness, anguish, and unity, that you are my kin. I want to personally reiterate the cold nature of the atrocities.
I love you!
Nor of the harrowing similarities between this loss and the losses of the past. I know that we stand here tonight in unity because this feeling is with us all. We have come far, yet have not come far enough. So that evening grass consumes the life of our kin and leaves the other alone, we have come far and we are still shadowed by haunts of bigotry and hate. About a month ago, on my commute, I met a young woman with a nice smile, and we chat idly, and then I noticed that there was some hostile comments cracking up behind us. Those insults were powerful, and I was silenced by them, then I was shamed by my silence, and the woman seemed to understand my alarm. Our comfort diminished while our smiles faded and the reality broke forth, and I wondered as to my pride, and I wondered about this new shame, and I quieted beside my arbitrary companion, thinking of my power. Where is my power at night alone against mere words? Am I really so alone at night passing through? I cannot reconcile the fear, as I cannot reconcile my anger and my feelings of outrage. So I am sure that what riddles our unity in these moments is loneliness, where we may be simply words. I cannot be alone in having fallen silent, subject to the quiet. But I am here before you, my kin, now. These moments alive in unity and strength and awareness. I resent the tragedy of those beautiful women, but let us rise up and against the fear and silence, through the isolation and the hate, and the name of beauty and love and justice.